Alright, so you guys had mentioned to me something last episode for me to try out here, and I'm actually going to do it real fast, just to see if it works, to see if you guys are correct or not. So, you had thrown out the idea, we have a look over here, after this room, we go to the duplicator room right here. I mentioned to you guys before that I have this thing called Void Bramble. If you didn't watch last episode, TLDR, it's a machine where, or it's a thing, machine? What the heck? It's a thing where if you walk in the middle of it, it'll teleport you to a random location. Could be hundreds of blocks away. These were duplicated off a dupe tree and are unable to be broken by anything. Usually they should just break like sugarcane right now, but they're not. So you guys just said, put dirt down, see if that breaks it. So we're gonna try that right now. Oh no. That's a little tricky. That's a little unfortunate, actually. So, dirt does not work. That doesn't work. Okay, well, that's a failure. Let's hop in. And we're just right outside our house. Sweet. Hello, everybody, and welcome to another episode of Crazy Crap. My name is Pizza Hunter Brandon, and really quickly before this video starts, I want to throw out something a little bit, precautionary, sort of. I've been kind of sick the past few days. I think today is the start of the third day. Apologies, I just heard my phone go off. I don't know where that was. I don't actually know where my phone is right now. But I've been kind of sick the past few days, and it's not like a normal cold. It's not like allergies or anything. It's like something to do with my stomach or something like that. I'm just having a few, like, very weird symptoms, and I'm probably going to be going to the doctor soon to get it checked out. It's rather strange, but, you know, don't worry. It's not, I'm not, you know, like, saying this to scare you and say, like, it's something serious. I don't know what it's going to be, but, you know, basically, the reason that I'm bringing this out right now, oh my days. You see right there? That's why I keep this door shut. That could have been really bad. I need to move these guys up. Like, I seriously need to move these guys up, like, one block, even though it would look a little bit worse. I really need to do that. My paranoia is just bleh. But anyways, I'm not saying that to scare anyone, because really you shouldn't be scared. I'm not, so don't worry. It's just the sort of thing, like, it does hinder my time of how long I'm able to be consistently at a computer for. So, if for whatever reason, like, the videos seem a bit shorter, or they seem like I didn't really do a lot of off-camera work, just know it's because I'm still trying to get out daily episodes of this, but because of this illness, I can't really sit down at a computer for 3 hours straight like I could before. Hopefully it'll be going away within the next couple days, but, yeah, just a little thing. So anyways, for today's episode, what I want to do, and you guys can see right here, I'm currently making, because I need to expand on this to build another room right now. You guys know how it works. Got three rooms attached to one of these little intersections, I guess I call them, or hallways, whatever it may be. I'm working on the hallway right now, and what I want to do this episode is actually, I want to start creating a new room as kind of like a showcase room. I've had this idea thrown around at me a couple times, and I actually think I kind of want to go through with it, because with CrazyCraft, I love, or just Minecraft in general, I love doing things that are huge projects and take a long while to create, you know, to finish, basically. And I think this is a really cool idea. So what I want to do is I want to create like a showcase room, or think of it like a hallway, and you have glass on your left, glass on your right, very common, used in a lot of maps. And inside of it, I want to house like pretty much a bunch of different types of mobs. And my goal is going to be initially to capture every type of mob from ore spawn, at least the mobs that can be contained in something like that. You know, ore spawn has the king and the kraken and stuff, but you can't really spawn those in. So I'm going to go ahead and I guess just get working on this little hallway right here. And then we're going to get structuring on that, because the thing is, this room is going to be primarily very, very long and thin. You know. Just like wiener schnitzel hot dogs. Sorry. Anyway, so what I need to do basically is, I'm pretty sure this room right here is going to be where I need to build it, because if we have a look outside of our house right now, this is Jerome's area. I don't know how far he's going to extend his place down here, but I don't want to build a thing like right here that basically cuts in, you know, like this giant area right here to where he's not allowed to build anymore and nobody else is allowed to do anything. I don't think anyone in this area will do anything with this place. But Jerome might wind up building something, and this might outstretch a little bit further on, so I don't want to disrupt Jerome's house. So we're going to build it out the way I'm looking, because there's literally nothing over here, and it's kind of like our territory if we claim it. And Mitch's place is incredibly far away. We're actually... If we make this series go on to 300 episodes, we'll probably wind up reaching Mitch's house. But yeah, so I'm going to go ahead and build it off in this direction here. But I'll catch you guys back once I'm done creating the little intersection here, just because I don't really want to bore you with that. You guys have seen this a million times before, so catch you guys back in just a second. So I finished up the, well, I didn't finish it, obviously. We have to install the beacons and stuff, and that's going to be a bitch. But I finished up the red room in here. I really like how the red hex plating looks. We've had, what has it been? Green for the first, blue for the second, purple for the third? Was it purple? Yeah, it's purple for the third. And then we have red. I like the red. I do. I think we need a bit more lighting in here, obviously. But I really do like the red. I will have to keep this door shut, though, to make sure that no mobs come into these guys, especially right here. I think it was actually this one that kept it open, though. Why do I not have torches on there? I don't have torches. Oh, my lord. Hold on a second. Why do I not... Oh, my jays. You know what's funny is I somehow always wind up finding out that there's... Why are there no torches on any of those? For some reason, these torches on these doors really love to just completely vanish sometimes. Let me actually go back through here real fast and get some more laboratory stuff and a laboratory door. The question is, actually, do laboratory doors have exchange energy? Laboratory door... You do have an exchange energy. Ooh, you know what? Actually, hold on a second. I'm going to take the laboratory door off of here for right now. I'm going to go learn this that way so I can pretty much have just unlimited entrances whenever I need them. Because I hate crafting, man. Like, crafting right now, it's turned into this thing. I'm like, do I really have to craft that? Or can I just EMC it? You know what I mean? It's like... Oh, please. The only thing that I really do wish is, though, is that I wish I had, like, this book that could be able to go in there so I could, like, pick stuff out while other things are being learned. But I guess you can't execute and learn at the same time. I guess that's... Actually, is that a true thing? Can you execute and learn at the same time? I'm talking like humans? I have no idea. Don't actually... anyway. So what we need from this right now is the laboratory door and laboratory blocks. So let's get... There we go, 64 of those, and let's get a laboratory door. In fact, actually, we're gonna need a few of these right now. So we can get three more laboratory doors, four in total. That should do it, I think, actually. Yeah, that'll do it, actually. Because we need three for the walkways, or the pathway, rather, and then we need one more to replace the one that I just broke down, which I think was right here. You were on the inside right here, weren't you? Yes, you were, okay. So that's open, and then we can go over here, close this one down. Perfect, and then we actually do have light bulbs on us right now, or torches, torches on us for right now. So let me go ahead and break down this little area right here. I love just, like, having resources to build, you know what I mean? It's just such a nice thing, just always having the things that you need. Fudge it, I hate when that, no, you know what, no. I hate it. Laboratory, where's my laboratory stack? There you go. For those wondering how that happens, basically, if you have a full inventory when you put things into your chisel, it'll suck it out of you. So I didn't actually have any of those. Fudging hate it. That is the only time I will very willingly go into creative mode, because fudge is freaking mod pack, man. Now these are supposed to be, I think these are supposed to be inward ones, like this, right? I think so. That should be changed to outward then, shouldn't it? I think it should be. I think this is actually supposed to be outward. Wait, hold on. This is supposed to be outward. I'm pretty sure... No. No, it's supposed to be this way. I think the door's supposed to be that way? I have a scheme that goes on with these. Let me see. Hold on a second. So you are... Yeah, okay. And then the ones to other rooms are inward. So it's inward... actually, no, that's outward, and then inward. Okay, so you're supposed to be actually then right here. That's better. Okay, perfect. So now things are actually the way they need to be. And then you are supposed to be like that. Yes, you are. And then we can do the same thing over here. So this is going to be the room that I'm going to do for the build, mainly because, like I mentioned before, it's the only one that actually has enough room to be able to do it. And this room is going to be huge, by the way. So we're going to need, like, every little inch of room that we can get. Let's go ahead and set up our second laboratory door right here. There we go. One and two. And the light bulbs over here. One and two. We don't need any mobs spawning in here right now. Especially... Okay, that one's still open. All right, laboratory block down right there. One, two, three. There we go. I still need to replace this with buttons, but I've been very lazy about that. I love Minecraft, man. You can get lazy in a video game. It's fantastic. All right, and torches down there. And I think we're good. We're going to need crystal torches for this area for right now, or later. But for right now, we'll just light it up with light bulbs just because, I don't know, I got them on me. Why not? There we go. Place this down. Okay, so now we need to actually figure out how far can you dig in this direction before you reach the Pac-Man spawner? Okay, so the Pac-Man wall is at Z12. So this is where the wall is going to be at Z13. So Z12, how far is this right here? This is 1. So you can basically build about 10, I want to say 10 blocks out to the right. So if we have any like really long mobs, we'll probably need to place them along the left here. So I'm thinking what we're going to do is like, I'm probably going to go ahead and actually get the, so this is why I have my haste villager, right? So check this out. We have haste 2 right now from the beacon. However, oh, actually, wait a second. We have haste 2 right now. Would this lucky villager that has... Wait, where's the lucky villager that has haste? Where are you? Are you this one? Are you the lucky villager that has haste? No, you're the other one. You have the haste? You have the haste. This gives haste 2. But I don't think... Oh, no. I might have actually interpreted this a completely wrong way. Haste 2, and then... Hold on a second. If we drink this right now, will I be able to break through things like... What's it called? Oh, I got some health boost from that. Will I be able to break through things like gravel, or no, sorry, like diorite and stuff really fast? Oh, no, you can't! Fudge, it has to be a higher level of haste. Well, that just made that villager completely pointless. Fudge! Damn it. I guess he's still good for like doing things outside, but I thought for some reason that you needed haste, anything higher than haste 1 to be able to work with that, but I guess we always had haste 2. Alright, well, I guess we won't be able to, like, break through andesite all that quickly, since you guys can see, you don't bleed through it like, you know, dirt, or, cobblestone right now. So I'm gonna go ahead and, get this room cleared out, and I guess I'll catch you guys back in just a second. I'm invisible right now, but you can't actually tell. And you still can't tell. Now you can tell. If this doesn't make you nervous, I'm not really sure what would. Those poor villagers. They don't know the troubles that I've saved them from. Anyway, so, I cleared out a little bit of an area here, kind of just like a little pathway to get started. This, as you can see, is pretty much right next to, well, you can pretty much see exactly how far of, you know, how much room we have to work with. Why am I taking damage? Oh, freaking skeleton, sup, dude. This is how much room we have to work with, really. Not a lot, but, like, actually a fair amount, considering the Pac-Man room is going to go... It actually goes not too far, considering how far this thing's gonna go. So, what we need to do now, pretty much, is try and figure out blocks that we want to do for the bottom here, the floor. Obviously, we're gonna need glass for the walls. We'll probably have grass be the preferred block that the mobs will, walk on, I suppose. Just because I feel it'll make it look a bit more, natural, I suppose, if the mobs, you know, are on grass. It's like natural terrain, even though a lot of mobs... Actually... I guess that would make sense for, like, a worm mob, I suppose. Now, the question is, do I have any grass learned right now? I do have grass learned, so we can go ahead and get a little bit of that. Let me actually, grew. Let me go ahead and throw out a lot of the cobblestone dirt that we've got here right now. Thankfully, I have all this learned, so I don't need any more of that. It's actually kind of cool, because I know more people are getting into the, equivalent exchange mod. I believe Mitch has already gotten into it, and I think he's already, like, completely done with it. And, I know Choco, actually, he's doing it very, very early. I don't know if I agree with that, but I know Choco's a lot more of, like, a technical guy. He likes jumping into things firsthand and building immense things from the start, so... Good on him. I would definitely recommend you guys go watch his perspective, so I think he's starting it up again. I don't know if it's daily, but regardless. So let's go ahead and get a bit of grass. I'm thinking maybe 2 stacks to work with. Actually, just 1 stack. Yeah, 1 stack of grass to work with for right now. Now, what do we want to do for the floor is a good question, because we'll need to be... Do we want to do grass for a floorway as well, or do we want to do some form of maybe cobblestone? Hold on a second, let me actually take a look at what you chisel cobblestone into. Oh no, definitely not cobblestone. Maybe stone though. Let me actually take a little bit of stone left from here. There we go. See what we can chisel this in here. Modern mafic masonry. This might actually... This isn't something you would use for a floorway, I don't think. But it could be used for a... Oh, God. Oh, Jesus. We are... Oh, God. Haste. Hello, haste. I am so sorry. Oh, my days. Okay. Well, this is not going to look the same as it once was. let me go ahead and put all this back there, and then this one back there. Okay. This might actually look good maybe for a roof? Does this look good for a roof? I'm not actually sure. I'm gonna have to try and figure out the blocks that I want to use for this in just a little bit here. Let's actually just get the glass set up, or one of the rooms, just to kind of demonstrate right now. The question is, as well, do zookeeper shards, hold on a second, I want to look this up. Do zookeeper shards have an EMC? Zookeeper Shard. If not, no exchange energy. Ugh. Okay. I know one mob drops Zookeeper Shards. You guys also told me which mob drops name tags, so I'll definitely do something with those soon. So let's do, we have the grass. Now we need the glass, which the glass would be, where's the glass that we've got here? Come on. Come on, show it up for me. Holy fudge, come on, just show it up. Glass, where are you? There you go. Fudge sakes. Okay, what can we chisel the glass into? We might have to figure that out for maybe. I don't want to do, like, a grid glass or any sort of things that look like iron bars. We want to make it look kind of natural how they are. And then for the walls, not really sure what we want to do for the walls either. Maybe these would be good for the walls. Let's actually go ahead and take a little bit of a look here. So first portal gun can go down right here, since we're going to obviously need a lot of these blocks. I don't really feel like running around my house all that much right now. All right, go in this room, shut the door. Go in this room, shut the door. Go in this room. So basically, let's go ahead and remove a good section right here. There we go. Remove the dirt from this, remove the dirt from up here. I don't know if we'll build up this high. We definitely want to make it, I think, I wanted to extend the walkway a bit further than the walkway you have in here. So the walkway is going to be 5 blocks wide. And then you have the grass here. Okay, so I'm thinking for this, what we could do then is this could be one of the first rooms. So obviously we would have the grass. Do we want the grass right around here? Or do we want the, I'm thinking maybe the grass right around here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I think 5 blocks should be a good amount of space for, hello zombies and skeletons. I think 5 blocks should be a good amount of space for a standard mob. I think we'll obviously need to make some bigger than others, you know, to accommodate for a certain mob size. Because I know we're going to be trapping things like a basilisk and stuff like that. So 5 out there, and I think just a 5x5 square in all honesty. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 should do it. And then we can get the wall set up later on. I don't know if we're going to theme them necessarily, or if we're going to keep them all grass in the same sort of style. We could theme them. And then for the glass, obviously, I would need to put some sort of wall along here to figure out what I'm going to do for the wall even. I love his haste, man, but like it does really break a lot of things that you don't intentionally want to break. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and try and figure out what we want to do for the walls here. And I guess I'll meet you guys back in a second. Okay, so I think I actually did find a block that I might want to use. The problem with CrazyCraft is like it's a great mod pack. And I mean, there's a lot of things to build. But if you compare it to a mod pack like Mad Pack, for example, it really doesn't have a lot of building blocks in it, actually. And it's kind of upsetting. I know I never really got into Mad Packs building all that much. I never really gotten into Mad Pack all that much, unfortunately. I know Mad Pack 3 is coming out, and definitely let me know whether or not you guys like to see me do it. Because I think Rob is definitely going to be doing it for sure. But yeah, I want to get back into that mod pack with a bit more building. All I know right now is there is this block called a... It's not factory block. It's a factory block. I don't think... That's a weighted storage cube. Never mind, it's the other way around. I don't think I've ever wound up actually using these before, if I can recall. What the fudge did I... Okay, there we go. So we got 32 factory blocks. I'm going to go ahead and pop one of these in the table real fast so I can learn it. Just for future, you know, if I ever need. So these things, basically... Let me go ahead and turn up my GUI scale a little bit here. We can chisel this thing. I love this view so much. This might actually look pretty good against the wall. Now, I know a lot of people on the server have used these before. I have never, I don't think, just yet. But actually... I'm trying to think, would this look good for like a wall or something? Like what about warm metal column wireframe? Maybe not actually. What about like metal plate with a little rust? How does this look? Definitely not. I don't think actually, I think I'm wrong. I don't think this has the right atmosphere that I'm looking for. Give me a second here. So I'm here in a single player world right now, and I actually found this one block called Holy Stone. Check this out. Listen to it as you place it. How crazy is that? That is so cool. And it gives off the little, I love blocks that give off particle effects. It's like a little ambiance sort of thing. I really love this. These are tea leaves. Cool. So I really, really actually like this. Now, the question is, though, I don't know how to craft it, considering with this world, for some reason, I think it's because I had cheats enabled. It won't actually let me see the crafting recipe. So this is called Holy Stone. So let's go ahead and, I guess, just dip into our multiplayer world and try and see if we can craft this, because I know Holy Stone actually does have an EMC value. Let's search up Holy Stone. There we go. Okay, it's in here. All right, so you create it with a feather. That's actually kind of cute. I like that. All right, so let's go ahead and grab a feather then. We are at the completely wrong place. Do I have a feather? Is actually a good question. I don't actually know if I have a feather anywhere here. Those are slime balls. I am bound to have a feather. Okay, I actually have one feather here. All right, very, very cool. I don't know if anyone's used holy stone in the server just yet. So we're gonna take some holy stone right here, and we're gonna go ahead and go to our favorite little place, the EMC table, and I guess just go ahead and learn that up real fast. And to chisel these, really, they have a bunch of different ways you can chisel them, but like, I think any of them looks good. Platforms look really cool as well. Like, that looks like, that's a really cool walkway, actually, and it gives a little particle effects as you're walking, too. I just love the sound of that. That's so cool. This is a really neat design. So let's go ahead and, I guess, just take, throw away a bunch of stuff for right now, I guess. And let's go ahead and grab up a few pieces of a holy stone here. So we should be able to just search up holy. There we go. So let's get two stacks of it. I think, actually, hold on. Let's go ahead and get another stack real fast. Just so we have two on us. Holy stone right there. Okay. And we might actually be able to use this for the roof as well. I moved up the diamond. I moved up the diamond chisel. I moved up the grass, by the way, one block just so it wasn't going to be right up against the wall. Okay. So holy stone. Ooh, there are a lot. This is a really, platform tiles looks really cool. Holy stone bricks. There's a holy stone plate and holy stone fancy tiles. Let's see how the there's smooth holy stone plate. Maybe let's try to smooth out. See how this looks. How do you look? Not really getting the vibe off that necessarily. Let's try the smooth. What was it? No. The other plates. Holy stone plate. What about you? Fudge off. You're not holy. Stupid spider. Ooh. That looks actually kind of cool. That might be a contender. I like that. What about mysterious holy stone? Oh no, that looks a bit strange. I mean, it's got like a cool design. Maybe we're to do that for like right here. No, I think we'll want something for the yeah, I think we'll want a different kind of material for the actual glass. So we'll do I don't know actually if I want to do glass along the sides here too and allow you to see all the way down or put a, like an opaque wall right here too. That's the thing as well. This looks so pretty, man. I love it. All right, maybe we can do the holy stone blocks or bricks as they're calling it. It doesn't really look as good in all honesty. Like it looks cool, but I kind of really dig this. But at the same time, I don't. Like I'm looking actually. That kind of looks neat. In fact, I think I actually might like that a bit better than this. Not sure though. Might actually take apart a little bit of this right here. Let's get in some new inventory space. Like holy fudge. Grass, that stone, the corn dogs. Stack the corn dogs, man. There we go. Now we got some inventory space. All right. Do you look better? Yeah, actually, I think this. Maybe we could actually use this holy stone for the roof here. Maybe we could use this kind of holy stone, the smooth holy stone for the plates rather for the walling, and then we could use the stone here for the roof because the roof is going to be, I would assume, about 3 blocks tall. So right about here, I think is going to be the roof. Let's actually build a little bit of the roof here just to kind of see. Is this what we're going to want to use for the roof, or do we want to use a completely different block? We might use a completely different block, in all honesty. Then again, it does kind of give like a really like it gives a really mysterious atmosphere to like there being like a hostile or friendly mob inside of this. If you think about it, it's like they're really enchanted, huh? So this is actually an idea I had trying to use wood for it, and I'm not gonna lie, I actually really like the wood. I didn't think that wood was gonna be something I wanted to use considering it was more like a default block, and I wanted to use something a bit crazier, I suppose. But it is a chiseled block, so I guess it is kind of like a crazy craft block. And to be fair, I think it actually really complements the look of like, I don't know, the grass and stuff just makes it look a bit more natural. So what we're gonna do right now, I guess, is just fill this up with our first pet really. And I don't know what we want to do with like the names or like where we want to name them, but let's just go ahead and out of here try and see where our zookeeper shards are. I know we've got a ton of them. I just don't quite remember what I did with them or where they are. I guess it's the same thing. I'm gonna actually have to search up zookeeper shards. I might have something. In fact, I think I actually know where they are. Hold on. They're not in here. They're in this chest right here. Yeah, we have 19 zookeeper shards right here. We got our Illuminati pet ready. Let me actually put some blocks away for right now. Put away the void stone, stone, water stone, Illuminati pet, or bee. Oh, we got a dry bee spawning. Okay. bad. Awful. Okay, so we have a Zookeeper Shard. Let's, I guess, just jump through the, what is it? Just grab a random egg out of here and see what we get. Pretty much just, like, maybe the first one we pick up, a Brutal Fly. Ooh, we might not actually have enough room for that. You know what? I think in the spirit of Mitch and Jerome's prank, I think we're gonna go with a WTF. Mainly because, Mitch and Jerome pranked me with these if, you know, you guys didn't watch it or whatever. So I think we're gonna go with this for our first mob. Just to, you know, kind of, I guess, symbolize stuff. So let's go ahead and, spawn one of these guys in here and smack him with a Zookeeper Shard and put the bubble glass back up. And that is our first... It's our first hostage, really. So this guy's just kind of gonna be in here and he's gonna chill in here for a little while. And, I guess really, like, we're just going to build out as far as we pretty much can with these, creating, I guess, a few more of these rooms. So I'm going to go ahead and do that real fast, get some mobs, and we'll put them in here. Obviously, we're going to need to make some rooms larger than others for mobs like Basilisks or whatever, because they'll need a bit more than 5x5 space. And as a last thing you guys can see here, there's actually 6 pieces of grass this way and 5 this way. That's because the actual room that he's in is a physical 5x5. This glass prevents him from anything else. We could have actually put solid air here. Ooh, I'm actually curious how that would look. And I kind of almost want to see it again. Apologies on my phone going off. I'm going to go ahead and create this room here. And I'm going to see how a solid air would look. So I'm not sure if mobs can get through that. I don't think they can. So we might actually see whether or not that would... is this rough or just holy stone? I think it's rough holy stone bricks. Yeah, it's rough ones. Oh god, this noise is something that's going to make me really... Oh, it's hostile creatures already off? Oh, I don't know what he is, but I guess he's a non-hostile creature, I suppose. So I'm going to go ahead and get this set up and we'll take a look... Already? The timing on this Illuminipe is seriously off, by the way. What am I going to get from this guy? Present. Okay, black present. Not too bad. Nothing in. I know it's not how they work, but, you know, I hope there's a present or something. And I don't think you're going to eat anything in there. You shouldn't, at least. Okay, so, yeah. Okay, so let's have a look here. So let's go ahead and pick up our solid air blocks, which I believe are right here. This might actually look a lot better. In fact, while I'm here, I might as well pick up another spawn egg so we can put them in here. Do we want to do maybe, I guess we shouldn't really be all that, like, picky with this right now. We can do Mobzilla. I think Mobzilla might fit in there pretty well. Now, let's do a Gazelle, since that was the first one we popped our head on, and I don't know, might as well, in all honesty. Alright, we can toss out the rest of these for now. And, let's just hop back through our little portal here and see how this would look. So, if we put down a Gazelle, man, fudge my freaking inventory! I don't know why it's so messed up right now. I feel like I need everything in here, and, like, I kinda do to an extent, but, like, ugh, it's so obnoxious having all this junk in here that I don't need, throwing it all out. Don't need coal, don't need... That's about it. I need pretty much everything else in here. I don't need this stuff, but let's go ahead and, I guess just put the solid air down right here. You know, I almost like it where, like, you can see the... I think that's the reason why I'm not necessarily the biggest fan of the solid air. We can give it a shot right now. Do that, slap that down, and do the solid air from here. I think I like the, what is it? Oh, actually, because, like, you can't get through there. On this, I don't know. Like, I think, I actually do think I like the solid air better, because it does seem a lot more natural. This does seem like it's caged a little bit. Let me actually break open the majority of this here and remove this and just place on solid air instead. Mainly because I think if we can get like a little view of what both of them would look like side by side, I'll probably be able to decide a bit easier. I think we're going to go with the solid air in preference. I think that looks really good. I think I just completely messed up how that looks. Yep. Alright, there we go. I think that definitely looks better, for sure. And the mobs can't get out by itself. Okay, alright, not bad. So then, for those curious, by the way, I'm sure you're not, but I'll just tell you anyway. Can I turn, is it friendly creatures off? Oh my gosh, I think I have to turn my sound down to get rid of you. Why did I put you in first? Fudgy, now I know why Jerome and Mitch did that to me. I hate these guys and the freaking noise. It's a really satisfying noise, but don't get me wrong, it is still highly obnoxious. Oh my days. Anyway, so the grass is basically going to go down pretty much the immediate one next. There's not going to be two of these ones. This will just be like the one in the middle here. You know, pretty much just one block dividing both of them. just for right now, I'm just going to have every sound off. I know you guys are probably going to be like, oh, I need Minecraft music. Trust me, I know. I really do know, but I'm probably going to get rid of you. Oh, God. I'll need to make sure not to punch these guys. That's one thing. Is that good? And that's good. Okay, I'll need to make sure not to punch any of these guys, but I'll tell you what. I'm going to have a very difficult time. What is it? I don't even know. I'm probably gonna have to break that and replace him with another mob just because this guy's way too obnoxious right now. I'll probably keep him in, like, later on when I don't, you know, like, I'm actually down to, like, the last mobs I'm collecting. But, like, we've got a lot of collection to do in this because there are a lot of mobs in this mod pack. I guess we can go off of our morphs as well. I just hate the fact that all my morphs got reset, man. I mean, like, wait a minute. Wait. Do I have all my morphs back? No. Are these all the morphs that I've gotten just by playing the game? Hold on. I'll be able to tell if there's a Kraken in here. There's a giant. I think the majority of this, though, is from Lucky Blocks. I'm not seeing a Kraken. And I'm not seeing... where was the other one? No. Okay. Yeah, my morphs did get reset, and this is currently what I've got right now. I don't think I have a Kraken in there, unfortunately. But... you know, some things suck, the other things don't, and that's one of those things that suck. I really wish I could have been one of those lucky people to not have to reset my entire series, but, happens to the best of us. Let's go ahead and place down the rest of the wood here and get this whole thing finished. And, so this is what it's pretty much going to look like here. We need a bit more holy stone, though. Do I have any more holy stone on me? I don't believe I do, and I don't think I tossed any there. Let's go back through here and head back to our equivalent exchange table and get a bit more holy stone. There we go. Chisel this thing up to, I believe, was it the... it's a smooth, isn't it? Yeah, we need the smooth right there. Okay, so we can go ahead and right-click that. Whenever the lag would go away. I think just lag has become a natural thing on the server, and I'm not sure what someone did, but, like, lag spikes... oh, this is actually a lag spike lasting a little while. Ah, that lasted quite a while. Lag spikes seem to be a thing. I just, like... I don't know. They just seem to exist on the server, and that's really about the gist of it. Now, was it this one that I think I had set up to the right here? Yeah, it was. Okay, it's the last holy stone right there. I really love how it gives the little, like, dramatic effect. How it's all, like, the particle effects right there. Really, really cool. So let's get the rest of the holy stone done up on the roof as well with the rough holy stone blocks. There we go. And we have another one of these created. It doesn't take a long while for these to work either. And the stone bricks chisel us up into... stone bricks, just the disordered one, okay? And we can have this thing go down, extend all the way through here. It's really easy room to build because all these materials, I can get them through the table, and they're even pretty basic materials to create if I wanted to make more of them on my own. I'm obviously going to need to figure out a roof situation here, too. Not sure what I want to do with the roof, though. Probably, I'm not actually sure if I want to make the roof, like, right here, or if I want to bring it down one more, like, where this block would be like this, or if I want to just keep it the level it is right now. Not actually sure. So anyways, the next mob that I think we're going to do is, really, I have no idea. Let's just go back through the other one here. I'm going to have to make, like, a checklist of mobs that I have, and I guess just, like, cross them off. You know what I mean? Like, once I've gotten a certain amount of them. And I'll actually need to figure out what mobs in here aren't from ore spawn, because I don't know what other mods in this mod pack actually make a lot of mobs. So we can do, I guess, maybe... do I do the leaf monster for the next one? Let's do the leaf monster for the next one. I don't know. I freaking love this guy. Probably should have let that other one circulate in there. Okay, so let's go ahead and run back through here and jump in. I think we're clear to put noise back on as soon as I get this one set up. So let's put that, slap him on there, and oh god, solid air quickly. Oh god, do it fast. This guy's really quick. All right, there we go. He's trapped in. He's all, like, afraid now. All right, dude, no need to hide. You're pretty much trapped forever. He's again chilling there, isn't he? Oh man, this room is actually dark as hell without my ocelot pet. This ocelot pet still doesn't even give, like, the perfect night vision it needs to right now, but I definitely should probably get that set up a bit more. Anyways, I think that's going to go ahead and do it for this episode. I mean, we've got a pretty clear idea of how we want these to work, and I guess actually what I should be doing first before we end off the episode is let me get a bit more of the framed fancy signs. And we've got 64 of them now. Holy crap. Let me go ahead and dump out one of these blocks right here. I actually got scared of a creeper for the first time in a while. not usually afraid of those guys. Where do we want to put the... do we want to put him, like, right here? Because if I put him right here, I'll have to pretty much have the roof. We could put him to the right side here. Yeah, we could put him to the right side. Like, this is the WTF. Or we could actually... we could put it right there, even. We might want to do that. I think that actually fits a bit more, in all honesty, having the signs. Actually, nah, that looks a little bit abnormal, to be honest with you. Let's go ahead and actually take this down and just put it on the right wall. Are you gonna take a while? Oh God, broke the air right there. I broke the air. You'll never hear me say that pretty much anywhere else in my life, unless I fart. Never mind, you'll hear me say it quite a lot. Okay, let's go ahead and get rid of our gunpowder right here, and I guess just change this up here. So we have this right in the middle right there. Text scale up to times 4, so WTF, and we can have this thing pretty much just moved over to the middle. WTF right there. I think. Oh God, that looks really weird. Hold on a second. Let me change it to right about there. Yeah, that looks pretty good right there. And then this guy is a leaf monster, so we can do the same thing for him. We want it text scale times 4, so we can do leaf monster. Oh God, we actually need to change that down a little bit and go right about here. There we go. Text scale 3, leaf monster. There we go. Is that good? That's good right there. And then this other one right here can be the. Oh, he's trying. What is he walking on? Oh, I think I have solid air placed. Do I have solid air placed down in there? No, I don't. He's just levitating. Unless there's a solid air block. Oh, yeah, right there. There it is. Gotta make sure I don't do that by accident. All right. So then we can put the gazelle one down. I guess we want to do it the same. Yeah, we want to do it the same way. Okay, so gotta make sure I spell this right too. I think gazelle is Gazelle. Yeah, okay, just making sure. All right, gazelle. There we go. Perfect. And we can have this thing right up to the center. All right, perfect. So this is pretty much how we're gonna have the room, and this thing is gonna extend out really far out. Gonna have to make sure that this doesn't intrude or anything like that, because we are going quite a bit out, also into the water. I don't know how far out it's gonna go, but yeah, it's gonna go ahead and do it for this episode, guys. Hopefully you enjoyed. If you did, be sure to show some support. Again, I actually really feel bad because, like, I want to put more time and effort into these videos. If I could spend a lot more time at the computer right now, I would more than likely be building up like 20 of these to start off the episode. But unfortunately, I have to end it here because I'm just not feeling well enough. I can record. Like, I'm feeling well enough to record, but, like, I'm not feeling well enough to be, you know, like, my normal grindy out Pete self, you know what I'm talking about? So, I'll catch you guys back in the next episode. I'll try and do a bit more off-camera work after I get this episode posted. But, yeah, hopefully you guys liked it. If you have any ideas for, like, the roof or anything, be sure to let me know. And, yeah, take care. Catch you guys back next time. Ciao!